Very good morning, dear students. In this video, I am going to explain about few other general properties of group 15 elements. So, in that, the next property is nature of bonding. Okay, that means these group 15 elements, how they can form bonds and what type of bonds are found by this group 15 element, that we'll see in this video. So, firstly, so the compounds found by this group elements are majorly covalent in nature. Okay, so most of the compounds found by the group 15 elements are covalent in nature. Especially nitrogen and phosphorus can form ionic nitrates and phosphites. Okay, along with the covalent property, nitrogen and phosphorus can also have the property to form ionic compounds. That means they can form ionic nitrates and phosphites. Ionic nitrates and phosphites. So, example is ionic nitrates are N-3 and phosphites are P-3. So, why they are forming such kind of ionic products means because of high electronegativity. Okay, if you observe an electronegativity, that is the property to attract the bonded electron pair. Such electron attracting bonded electron attracting property is very high for nitrogen and phosphorus. Due to containing such high electronegative property, these nitrogen and phosphorus can form ionic nitrates and phosphites. Okay, and strength of the covalent bonding decreases down the group. See, whatever the compounds are formed, covalent compounds are formed, the strength of these covalent compounds formed by the 15 group elements, that decreases down the group. Okay, that means topmost elements can form the strongest or stable covalent compounds. Okay, next one, multiple bonding properties also there for this group elements. Along with the single bond, they can also able to form double and triple bond. That means multiple bonds are also formed by this group 15 elements. So in the case of nitrogen, nitrogen can form p pi multiple bond with itself. Okay, so nitrogen can form p pi multiple bond with itself and also with the carbon and oxygen. So nitrogen other elements can make a multiple bond. It may be a double bond or triple bond. How it is forming? By using p orbitals. Okay, p orbitals of one nitrogen and p orbital of another nitrogen involved in pi bond formation, so that it is known as p pi bond. Even in this case, here in place of X, we can take carbon or oxygen. Okay, even here nitrogen uses p orbital and carbon and oxygen of p orbital involved in pi bond formation. Okay, in both the atoms only p orbital is utilized for the formation of pi bond, so that it is known as p pi bond. Okay, that means nitrogen can able to form p pi multiple bond with itself and also with the carbon and oxygen. Okay, that means here it uses only p orbitals. Okay, it uses only p orbitals to make multiple bonds such as pi bonds, and it cannot use d orbital. Why it is not using d orbital to form multiple bond? Because there is no vacant d orbital in the case of nitrogen. If you see nitrogen atomic number is what? 7. It can form 1s2, 2s2, 2p3 as the configuration. So outermost configuration is 2s2, 2p3. Okay, see here only 5 electrons are present in valence shell. There is no d orbital. Due to the absence of d orbital, it cannot use this d orbital for making pi bond. Okay, so that nitrogen can form only p pi multiple bond. Okay, with itself and with carbon and oxygen. Whereas other elements such as phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth, at least they will be having a vacant d orbital. If at least vacant d orbital is available, they can accept the electrons and they try to make the bond. But in case of nitrogen, there is no such type of vacant d orbitals also, so that they cannot form d pi p pi bonds. It can form only p pi p pi bond, so that it leads to give an inert compound such as N2. N2 is inert. That N2 is having the structure N triple bond N. Between the two nitrogen atoms in N2, triple bond is located, so that it is inert in nature. And other members unable to form pi bonds because of their larger size. Okay, so they do not form strong pi bond. Remember, they do not form or they are unable to form strong pi bonds. okay, so they are not able to form strong pi bonds. They can make pi bonds, but they are weak in nature. Why they are weak? Due to larger atomic size. Therefore, they are solids in nature and have complex structures. Example, phosphorus. Phosphorus can exist in a solid that is P4. Okay, that is white phosphorus. Now we'll see about the chemical properties, some general chemical properties of group 15th elements. So in that first one about nitrogen. Nitrogen is a diatomic colorless gas. If you see nitrogen, always it will be represented by N2. That means it is containing two nitrogen atoms. If two atoms are involved in a bond formation, that is known as diatomic. So nitrogen is a diatomic and it does not have any color. So we can say it is a colorless and gaseous in nature. Okay, it is gaseous. Physical state is gaseous in nature, colorless, and diatomic molecule is known as nitrogen. And two nitrogen atoms held together by using a triple bond. Okay, between the two nitrogen atoms, here two nitrogens are present. These two nitrogen atoms are held together by a triple bond. Okay, and have high bond dissociation energy, and they have high bond dissociation. Bond dissociation means the energy which is required to break the bond. The energy required to break the bond is known as bond dissociation energy. So that energy required for breaking this bond is very high. Why it is very high? Due to having a triple bond. Okay, three bonds are present between the two nitrogen atoms. To break these three bonds, it requires more and more amount of energy, so that automatically its bond dissociation energy will be very high. Okay, so that is almost about 945 kilojoules per mole. So this much amount of energy we require to break the triple bond present between the two nitrogen atoms. Okay, so the two nitrogen atoms in diatomic molecule of nitrogen is connected or held together by a triple bond, and it has more dissociation or high bond dissociation energy. It nearly required 945 kilojoules per mole amount of energy to break the triple bond present between the two nitrogen atoms. And due to having high bond dissociation energy, the reactivity of nitrogen is automatically decreases. That means it is highly stable. Okay, so stability is inversely proportional to reactivity. Okay, stability is inversely proportional to reactivity. Once the stability increases, reactivity decreases. Now this nitrogen atom is highly stable due to containing a triple bond between the two nitrogen atoms. So due to containing the more stable bond, the reactivity of nitrogen automatically decreases. That means due to containing more bond dissociation energy or high bond dissociation energy, the reactivity of nitrogen is automatically decreases. And next one, it reacts at drastic conditions. Drastic means at very high temperature, high pressure, or by using a special catalyst, only the nitrogen can undergo reaction. That means it reacts only under drastic conditions of temperature and pressure. Special conditions are high conditions of temperature and pressure. It reacts at drastic conditions. This reactivity at drastic condition of any element is known as chemical fixation of nitrogen. Okay, now we are studying this drastic condition about nitrogen. So it is known as chemical fixation of nitrogen. So whatever the element which can undergo reaction at very high temperature and pressure or drastic condition, that is said to be chemical fixation of such element or chemical fixation of nitrogen. Now phosphorus can exist in P4. This is about nitrogen chemical general properties. Okay, now see about phosphorus. Second element of this group is phosphorus. Phosphorus exists as P4. Okay, and only single bonds are present. If you see phosphorus, this is the central atom. It is connected with three other phosphorus atoms. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, if you see this phosphorus, between all the phosphorus atom, only single bonds are present. Between all the phosphorus atom, only single bonds are present. So, it can exist as a solid. Okay, phosphorus exists as P4, and between all the four phosphorus atom, only the single bonds are present. So, it is solid in nature. White phosphorus is quite reactive. Okay, so there are different types of phosphorus. In last class, we have seen about the types of phosphorus. Phosphorus can exist in different types of physical states. White phosphorus, red phosphorus, and other types. Yellow crystalline phosphorus. Different types of phosphorus I have given while explaining allotropic forms of phosphorus. So in about all the different allotropic phosphorus, white phosphorus is quite reactive. Okay, so it catches fire in air. That white phosphorus is highly reactive. So whenever it is exposed to air, that white phosphorus immediately undergo reaction with air. So we should not store this phosphorus which is exposed to air. It should be stored under water. Okay, white phosphorus among different allotropic forms of phosphorus, white phosphorus is quite reactive. It catches fire. Okay, in air, so it must be stored under water. And another type of phosphorus is red phosphorus. Red phosphorus is stable, reacts on heating. Okay, usually it is stable, but it reacts on heating. That means here what we are doing, we are increasing the temperature. Only on increasing in heat energy, then only it can undergo reaction. But at normal condition, red phosphorus do not undergo reaction. Okay, but at normal condition, red phosphorus do not undergo reaction because it is highly stable. Red phosphorus is stable, but it undergo reaction on heating. Okay, so next, reactivity of other elements decreases from arsenic to bismuth. So what are the elements present in this 15th group elements? Nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Okay, among all we have seen about nitrogen and phosphorus. Now we want to see about general chemical reactivity of arsenic and bismuth. Ask arsenic, antimony and bismuth. So the reactivity of these three elements decreases from arsenic to bismuth. That means among the three, arsenic is highly reactive and bismuth is least reactive. Okay, that is about chemical reactivity, in general chemical reactivity of group 15 elements. Now we'll see about the first chemical property of this group 15 elements, that is about oxidation state. What is meant by oxidation state? The property to form different types of here it is forming the positive oxidation states or negative oxidation states. Okay, so due to containing NS2 NP3 as the general configuration of group 15 elements, this is the general outermost configuration of group 15 elements. Because of having such a group 15 general configuration, they can able to form oxidation states from -3 to +5. Okay, from -3 to +5. Why they are forming -3? Because in its outermost p orbital, it is containing only 3 electrons. Still, it has the space to fill 3 more electrons. Okay, if it allows 3 more electrons, then it will be existing in -3. Why minus here? Because it is taking electrons. Whenever it takes electrons, that means it is accepting negative charge. It can show negative oxidation state. If suppose all the 5 electrons lost by the element, okay, what it is losing? Negative charge. Whenever it loses negative charge, it tries to exist in positive oxidation state. If the element of group 15 element loses all the 5 electrons present in the valence shell, it can able to show +5 oxidation state. Okay, so these group elements are having the general outermost configuration as NS2 NP3. Because of having such a configuration, they can able to form the oxidation states from -3 to +5. From -3 oxidation state to +5. When they can form -3 oxidation state or negative oxidation state, if they gain electrons. Okay, if they gain electron, they can able to form -3. If they loses electrons, they can form +5 or plus oxidation states. Okay, now in that we'll see about negative oxidation states. Nitrogen and phosphorus can show oxidation state as -3. Okay, this is one of the negative oxidation state. Nitrogen and phosphorus both are ready to show -3 oxidation state. So example is Mg3 N2. okay, Mg3N2. Each magnesium can show plus 2 oxidation state. How many magnesiums are there? Totally 6. So it will show plus 6. So here minus 6. That means it is shared by 2 nitrogen atoms, minus 3 and minus 3. So in Mg3N2, each nitrogen atom can show minus 3 oxidation state. Even in NH3, if you see NH3, it is one of the compound of nitrogen. We know hydrogen can able to form plus 1 oxidation state. How many hydrogens are there? 3. So all the 3 can show plus 3. So that nitrogen will be having minus 3 oxidation state. Like that even in calcium phosphide. Okay. Ca3P2. So this Ca3P2 is also containing phosphorus. This phosphorus can exist in minus 3 oxidation state. That means they try to take the electrons from the corresponding element and they can show minus oxidation states or negative oxidation states. Next. Another point related to the negative oxidation state is that tendency to form minus 3 oxidation state decreases. Okay, decreases moving down. That means from coming nitrogen to bismuth, automatically the tendency to form minus 3 oxidation state decreases. Okay, nitrogen and phosphorus shows even minus 2 and minus 1 along with minus 3. Okay, along with minus 3 oxidation state, nitrogen and phosphorus can also able to show minus 2 and minus 1. Example, NH2OH. Okay, in this case, nitrogen is now in minus 1 oxidation state. That means here, nitrogen and phosphorus can also show other oxidation states other than minus 3, that is minus 2 and minus 1. That is about the negative oxidation states. Next, about positive oxidation state. So these group elements can also show positive oxidation state such as plus 3 and plus 5. So when we move down the group, stability of plus 5 oxidation state decreases and plus 3 oxidation state increases. If you move from down the group, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Down the group, plus 5 oxidation state decreases. Okay. And down the group plus 3 oxidation state increases. This is due to inert pair effect. So what is meant by inert pair effect? The reluctance of s electrons to participate in bonding. That means these s electrons, what are the s electrons, where these s electrons from? So general configuration is ns2 np3, right? So see here, ns electrons, how many ns electrons are there? 2 ns electrons are there. So these two s electrons are not ready to participate in bonding. The pair of electrons, are they exist in pair form? Yes. So the pair of electrons which are not allowed for bonding formation is known as inert pair. That means they are very inert for forming a bond. Okay, that pair which is not easily involved in bond formation is known as inert pair effect. So due to having inert pair effect of the elements present at bottom most, they can able to show plus 3 oxidation state. That's why plus 3 oxidation state down the group increases and plus 5 oxidation state down the group decreases. This is due to inert pair effect. Now, compounds in plus 5 oxidation state, whatever the compounds exist in plus 5 oxidation state, they are completely covalent in nature. The compounds which can exist in plus 5 oxidation state, they are completely covalent. Example, PFI, phosphorus pentafluoride, phosphorus pentachloride, antimony pentafluoride, bismuth pentafluoride, all these are completely covalent because the oxidation states of the elements here are plus 5. Okay, so due to containing plus 5 oxidation state, these elements can, or these compounds can exist in covalent state. Now, nitrogen does not form NF5 or NCl3, okay, in plus 5 oxidation state. Why it is not forming plus 5 oxidation state means due to the absence of d orbital. So, this point I have already told you. So, in nitrogen, there is no vacant d orbitals. So, that it is not able to show plus 5 oxidation state. Very, very, very important point. Why nitrogen do not form plus 5 oxidation state, or why nitrogen do not exist a compound such as NF5? The reason behind this is due to the absence of d orbital, or it does not have vacant d orbital, so that it is failed to form NF5, or it does not exhibit plus 5 oxidation state. Okay, next, nitrogen shows plus 5 oxidation state in N2O5. In this case, only the nitrogen can show plus 5 oxidation state, but that is due to forming coordination bond. with oxygen. So this is not completely covalent bond, this is coordination bond. By making coordination bond, nitrogen can show plus 5 oxidation state, that is only in the case of N2O5. Example, in N2O5, covalency of nitrogen is just plus 4. About covalency, I'll tell you later. So nitrogen is having the covalency as plus 4, but oxidation state is plus 5. So why this plus 5 oxidation state it is showing? Because of forming coordinate bond with the oxygen. Due to forming coordinate bond with the oxygen, so this nitrogen can show plus 5 oxidation state in N2O5, but its covalency is just 4 in this compound also. Okay, along with these oxidation states, nitrogen can also show plus 1 in N2O compound, plus 2 in NO compound, plus 4 in N2O4 and NO compound. That means nitrogen can able to show variable oxidation states. Variable in the sense different oxidation states. Okay, this is about the oxidation states of group 15 elements.